Hi everyone, welcome to part 3 of approaches to measuring performance. Make sure to stay till the end and to check the rest of the parts out. Let's do some recap. Performance is multidimensional, hence we must consider many different types of behaviors to understand performance. Although there are many types of behavior, there are two types of behaviors or performance facets that stand out. First, we have task performance. As you can see, these are the textbook definitions of task performance. To simplify, task performance describes the core job responsibilities of an employee. It is also called in-role prescribed behavior and is reflected in specific work outcomes and deliverables as well as their quality and quantity. Examples of task performance are such as specification of task actions. This is one of the crucial elements which is used to measure the task performance of the employee. The employees must fulfill all the specifications of the task to accomplish it successfully. Specification of task constraints. This measure is used to check that whether the quality of the task is maintained. Along with this, it should be done within task duration and the given budget. Specification of results. It means that whether the accomplished task matches with what was required of it. In simple words, the outcome of the task is measured against the requirements. Specification of roles. It defines the key responsibilities and roles that person need to perform while working on some specific tasks. Next up, we have contextual performance. That can be defined as persisting with enthusiasm and exerting extra effort as necessary, for example, being punctual and rarely absent, expending extra effort on the job, volunteering to carry out task activities that are not formally part of the job, such as suggesting organizational improvements, and making constructive suggestions. Helping and cooperating with others, such as assisting and helping coworkers and customers. Following organizational rules and procedures, such as following orders and regulations. Showing respect for authority, complying with organizational values and policies. Endorsing, supporting, and defending organizational objectives, such as organizational loyalty, representing the organization favorably to outsiders. This can be simplified as going beyond formal job responsibilities or discretionary extra role behavior. Finally, there is an additional type of behavior that is another facet of contextual performance, which is voice behavior. It can be defined as non-required behavior that emphasizes expression of constructive challenge with an intent to improve rather than merely criticize. Last but not least, both task performance and contextual performance should be included in the performance system as both contribute to organizational success. Thank you and see you guys in our next video.